is one and only.
Yeah.
And there is nothing greater than Allah.
Yeah.
Who is Allah praying to?
You have to first learn, research, and then you have a debate. Because right now you don't have a debate. You're just screaming for no reason. You're saying barbecue and fish and stuff like, what are you talking about?
Blessings,
barakah.
Why?
Are you trying to tell me Allah fails to communicate when he says barakah? He means something else.
Okay.
All the words in the Quran.
She's using Google Translation.
You know, if you try to shut me down, it doesn't
Google
work.
Translation.
Because it just proves.
We're not trying to shut you down. That's the thing.
I'm
trying to make you understand.
Make my point.
Google Translation.
Go to Surah 23, verse 56.
Yes,
we in corpus.com. Okay, that's the website. You see every word in the Quran. And how they, what are they means, what are they roots, okay?
Sometimes, you know,
you go copy, you go to the Surah 33 verse 56. Here is the old words, okay? Link with that Yasaluna word, okay? How many pages? Approximately 5 pages.
I beg you, be quiet. You have an empty debate. There's no debate over here. You're just chatting. You're just shouting for no reason. You've translated something wrong, and now you're just shouting at everyone.
We don't want you to
shout. I translated something wrong.
Yes, you did.
I'm making my case. Brother, hold on. So, here's the website. Muslim website on the languages tells us word means is the prayer. He's the, okay, all the words are here, guys. Okay, all of them.
Okay, which translation?
And
which translation?
Muslim, Islamic Dawatim. Arabic.
Okay.
Islamic Dawatim.
Sorry.
In a platform, stood up and then confirmed that word is meaning prayer. Okay? My question to the Muslims. If your Islamic Dawatim, who is Arabic is the first language, tells us it's a prayer, which confirms with the Quranic language as the prayer, okay? Who do you think you are telling me it's a blessing? While there is an Arabic word for blessing.
First, learn Arabic. First, learn Arabic. Understand the Arabic language. Then you understand that when you're reading the sentence, it doesn't say that Allah is praying towards someone. Like you're crazy like that. You have to understand the meaning and the
Allah. It's Allah.
You have to understand the proper international, like the Sahih translation. Not just word by word translation. Arabic and English is not.
Yeah, we like
you don't need
like
to know my name.
I'm Abdullah.
That's it, slave of Allah.
Okay. And as we have the slave of Allah here, so
we're all slaves of Allah, by the way.
I am the child of God. I was a dog, and then I become a sheep. Now I am the sheep of that shepherd. Also, I am the child of God.
Right,
so now.
You're a sheep and a dog?
You.
What are you talking about?
I'm going to read you something. I want you to explain this to me because, okay? So, Surah 33, verse 56. I made my case that Allah prays, you are disagreeing with me, okay? And then you said Allah is sending blessings. I am reading the hadith for you. Listen very carefully, okay?
And build altars and sacrifice a goat or sheep upon them.
Tirmidhi, 1387. Okay? Messenger of Allah said.
What verse is it?
1387. Hadith number. Allah and His angels. And the people of the heaven and the earth, even the ants are in their rocks, and the fish pray.
Why
pray. Listen carefully.
Fact check.
She might be lying.
And the fish pray for blessing. Can you just explain it to me? How does Allah pray here? And whom Allah does pray for blessing?
I swear I didn't hear anything he said.
Okay, I'll repeat it again. Okay? Tirmidhi 1387. Messenger of Allah said, Allah and his angels, Allah and his angels, and the people of the heaven and the earth, even the ants in their rocks, and the fish pray for blessing on those who teach people good. Who is Allah praying to? My question.
Open Surah 9103. You can't take the Quran out of context, use the word in one time.
I don't trust whatever you're reading right now, innit?
Go to Surah 9103.
I know, we cannot trust the Tirmidhi, we cannot trust the Quran, therefore, we should not be trusting
things out of context.
Are you Arabic scholar?
If you're going to read something, read it from beginning to end, not just like take out big points.
Give me the context of the hadith.
I'll tell you the context. The same wording is used in another verse. Why don't you check that verse, what it says?
Same wording, Surah 2 verse 157, Surah 33 verse 43, Surah 33 verse 56.
Surah 9 verse 103.
Allah is praying. Now I am looking at the hadith. I want to know who Allah, angels, even the ants, the fish are praying for blessing. Who is Allah praying to?
Allah doesn't need to pray. We're going back to the same argument where you need to learn your Arabic context first. You can't pinpoint each Arabic word.
Please educate me. And
educate yourself. I'm not a teacher here to educate you. Go home and actually start researching.
I'm telling you, look at this verse.
Then come back and then maybe you won't even have a case to argue about here. When you go home, learn. Learn. Don't just start reading out of context and start shouting out in front of everyone saying, you know,
you don't know Arabic.
Start pinpointing, especially this guy over here laughing like that.
Do you know any Arabic?
Slaves of Allah, slaves of Muhammad, has no answer.
There's no slaves.
Who is Allah praying to?
How do you know it's praying?
Who is Allah praying? It has been translated by a Muslim scholar.
You're not listening.
Allah, the angels,
there's more than one meaning for prayer. You don't understand.
What is the meaning of the prayer when Allah does? Allah is giving people blessings.
Okay, what is your point? Let's say Allah is praying to man. What's your point?
I am going to go with that.
What is your point?
To just to say.
What point?
He contradicts Tawheed.
Huh?
He contradicts Tawheed.
So how does Allah contradict himself?
No, Quran. Because he's praying to himself. If Tawheed is true, Allah is praying to himself.
Muhammad. Make a point. When Allah prays, it means blessing. Okay? Which is just not butchering Allah, but even making barbecue from Allah. I'm not gonna deal with that.
Check verse 9103. Same word, same context. Verse 9103. Verse 9103. Surah 9 verse 103.
And I'm gonna put the blessing. Allah and angels and the people of the heaven and the earth, even the ants in their rock. And the fish, okay?
It doesn't even make sense what you're saying. How is Allah commanding us, the angels, himself to pray to Muhammad? Doesn't even make sense.
What are you reading?
Come with a stronger argument.
Listen, I beg you, go on a different website.
That's not on the website, so go to the Tin Media.
I don't know what translation you're reading from.
I butcher the
if you don't
prayer,
know Arabic, how you become a translation
and
for the Quran?
Instead of that prayer, blessing.
I'll get you synonyms
that?
For prayer. I'll get you synonyms.
I don't want you to get me the synonyms for prayer. I want you to just answer the question. Who is Allah?
There's 40,000 translations. Who says blessing? You're the only one who shake it. The one that says.
Yeah.
There's 40,000 translations.
Why did you choose Muhammad?
So how could recognize Muhammad?
My cameraman is being harassed, guys. Just beware of it. My cameraman is being harassed by lovely Muslims who follow the religion of peace.
When you're reading a book, you don't take one verse.
Okay.
Use it in the context.
Please go to him and say, you are not...
Bro, Muhammad Hijab,
prayer according to Google,
he went on stage
and earnestly told Allah, so he's wishing people blessings. That's what prayer is.
He said Allah prays and the angels for Muhammad, bro. So the question is, who is the hero of that prayer?
Prayer here is an earnest hope or wish.
So
he's wishing people blessings.
Muslims go to the Google to figure out what prayers mean.
I'm not going to Google, I'm giving you a synonym of prayer according to Google, according to the Oxford Dictionary. And the Oxford Dictionary, according to it, a prayer is an earnest hope or wish of blessings to the people. That's it.
Allah.
Yeah. He's hoping people an earnest hope or wish.
First, do your research. Do your research first. Learn the Arabic language, and then you're able to start talking. You can't just pinpoint an Arabic word and then you can use it as an against the field. You can't do that. You have to first learn, research, and then you have a debate. Because right now you don't have a debate. You're just screaming for no reason. You're saying barbecue and fish and stuff like, what are you talking about? Relax. Calm down. Go home and learn something, innit? Research the Arabic language. Don't stick to one website and start saying, oh, this is this, this is this. Learn.
What do you answer? How can you answer that? So he's wishing people an earnest hope. Yeah.
We all see the problem.
What's the problem?
We have a problem.
What's the problem?
Because the syntax.
Because
I have the syntax.
Islam has a problem.
What's the problem?
Problem is this. While Islam teaches,
I gave
Allah
you the answer. No, you shouldn't hate. I gave you the answer. Answer me back. What's against it? Can you oppose
syntax.
This?
Oppose
we are at speaker's corner, not at Sharia corner.
No,
I
know,
listen
I know,
to
exactly.
you. Now,
shh. I listen to you.
Don't
shush me. I listen to you the whole time. Now
so,
you listen to me.
Here is our problem. Muslim states that there is only one God.
Yeah.
He is identified so-called Allah. He's one and only. Okay?
Yes, exactly. He's the one and only.
That one and only.
And according
only,
to you, there is three gods.
That one and only
the soul,
Allah
I don't know
prays
and,
to someone for Muhammad. That one and only Allah with his angels, with his fish, with his birds, with his animals prays for blessing for people who does the good. If Allah is one and only, and there is nothing greater than Allah, who is Allah praying to?
He's
don't play that stupid junk with me, because books are confirming
he's
Allah is praying.
Hope or wish of blessings.
Okay.
What's saluna?
You
saluna.
It is the sake of the
praying.
You see what I mean? Look,
I know, you saluna
okay.
is a
let me translate it. Let me translate it. Okay. What it says, what wherever
prayer.
It comes out, pray.
There is more than one meaning to pray.
It's always pray.
There is more than one meaning
pray.
To many other words. Pray, spring, there is
the
more than one
the same word has been used.
The spring, springs
what
in
is,
the spring.
What
okay,
is the
what does
the
spring mean
in Arabic?
What?
Are you
what
blessings
is the meaning of the blessing in Arabic?
Blessings, barakah.
Why?
Are you trying to tell me Allah fails to communicate when he says barakah, he means something else. Even with my broken English, I know there is a difference between blessings and prayer.
I told you what
sir,
prayer means according to Oxford Dictionary, right?
Oxford Dictionary! Quran butchers
No, I'm not telling you.
It's not a kebab shop.
Allah is not praying for anyone.
I'm not going to speak anymore
because you're just hating.
You're just hating. Reading the Quran makes you to hate people. 1.84 Muslims are reciting the Quran. Watch out! Reading the Quran makes you hate. 1.84 billion Muslims are reciting the Quran. Watch out for those Muslims.